Testing the difference between two proportions. For example, a team of researchers were interested in determining if the performance of students has increased over the years. In 2010, a random sample of 1,000 students at a major university was selected, and it was found that 30% of them had a grade point average of 3.5 or higher on a scale of 4.0. A previous study in 2005 showed that 25% of 1,000 students at a major university had an overall grade point average of 3.5 or higher. At the 10% level of significance, is there sufficient evidence to conclude that the proportion of students performing well has increased over the years? To perform a test, we're first going to state the hypotheses. For the null hypothesis, the statement will always be P1 is equal to P2. Where P1 is the sample proportion of group 1 and P2 is the sample proportion of group 2. We are assuming once again that there is no difference between the proportions of the two groups. A team of researchers were interested in determining if the performance of students has increased over the years. Using notation, the alternative hypothesis will be P1 is greater than P2. Please note that greater than is being used because the test is performed to determine if there is sufficient evidence to conclude that the proportion of students performing well has increased over the years. Also, since we're using greater than, the students sampled in 2010 must be group 1, and the students sampled in 2005 must be group 2. So for group 1, we're using the students in 2010. And for group 2, we're using the students from 2005. For step 2, we're going to state the level of significance. And here alpha is equal to 0.10. For step 3, using the values from the scenario, make note of the sample proportion for each group. Recall the students sampled in 2010 must be group 1, and the students sampled in 2005 must be group 2. Again, be careful not to confuse the two groups. Therefore, the sample proportion for group 1 is 0.30, and the sample proportion for group 2 is 0.25. In order to use the formula for the test statistic, we will also need to determine x1 and x2, since only the sample proportions are provided. So for x1, which is the number of successes for group 1, we'll need to identify that first. And we'll also need to identify x2, which is the number of successes for group 2. The number of successes can be found by multiplying the sample proportion by the sample size. So for group 1, our sample proportion was 0.30. So we're going to take 0.30 times the sample size of 1,000, and we obtain 300. For group 2, the sample proportion was 0.25 times the sample size of 1,000, and that's equal to 250. And also, because we assume that there is no difference between the two groups, P1 minus P2 will always be 0. So using that information, we can go ahead and determine the test statistic. It follows a Z. And we have the quantity of p-hat-1 minus p-hat-2 minus the quantity of p-1 minus p-2. In the denominator, we're taking the square root of p bar times q bar times the quantity of 1 over n1 plus 1 over n2. So we'll need to identify these pieces first. Recall that p hat 1 is equal to x1 over n1, and that's point 30. P hat 2 is equal to x2 over n2, and that's equal to 0.25. P bar is found by taking x1 plus x2 and dividing that result by n1 plus n2. And so once we plug in the values for x1, x2, n1, and n2, we obtain a result of 0.275. Q bar is equal to 1 minus p bar. And so 1 minus p bar is equal to 0.725. So using this information, we can plug it into our formula, and we obtain the following. And recall that P1 minus P2 is 0 because we're assuming that there is no difference between the two groups. Once you perform the math on that, you obtain a z-test statistic equaling 2.50. For step 4, we're going to determine the critical value. Recall the direction of the alternative hypothesis was greater than, so we'll have a right-tailed test for this example. So we're going to shade to the right to show our rejection region, and that area under the tail is equal to alpha, which is 0.10. So since this follows a z distribution using the z table, we can determine the critical value to be 1.28. Our test statistic of 2.50 clearly falls in the rejection region, so we're able to go on to step 5 and state the decision as well as the conclusion. And the decision is to reject the null hypothesis. Our conclusion is the following. There is sufficient evidence to suggest that the proportion of students performing well has increased over the years.